Now to the latest on the pandemic with some good news to report tonight. The number of COVID-19 cases here on the First Coast and across the country, they're decreasing. That's according to Johns Hopkins University and Florida's Department of Health. Doctors tell On Your Side's Kaylee Tracy the decline isn't because of the vaccine.
We have the opportunity right now to end this pandemic here, or at least marginalize it to the point where we can get back to some sort of normalcy.
The opportunity to possibly end a pandemic that has plagued us for a year. Chad Nielsen, Infection Prevention Director at the University of Florida Health, says we need to seize on COVID cases across the country declining.
We want to ride this low on the wave and try and get people vaccinated to avoid another explosion this summer. The only way this is going to end is getting vaccinations out to as many people as can receive them and continue to social distance and wear masks.
According to Johns Hopkins University, the United States reported the lowest number of daily COVID cases Monday since October, close to 54,000. We've seen similar trends in Florida and Duval County. Take a look at your screen. Sunday, we saw the lowest number of daily cases in Florida since November, close to 3,800. Sunday was also the lowest number of daily cases in Duval since November, with 121. Nielsen says there's a few reasons for the decline.
We had a huge bump over the Christmas holiday, which was expected, and now we're on the back end of that.
And these charts show record highs in both Duval and Florida overall came after Christmas.
Other factors contributing to this, it's likely not going to be vaccinations. I don't think there's enough of the population vaccinated enough right now to make a difference there, but you're seeing good social distancing and masking.
Nielsen says he knows we're all tired, but don't let these numbers give you a false sense of security.
There is still an opportunity for this virus to continue to infect people and, in fact, push the numbers higher. We know that the UK variant is spreading in Florida. We know that most experts predict it's going to be the predominant strain here in the United States.
Kaylee Tracy, First Coast News, On Your Side.